Hello. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the live interactive session of image processing using fuzzy logic. I'm Vishaka Srinivasan from MATLAB Helper, and I have with me Gunjan and Nikita.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this live interactive session. Hope you guys would have been enjoying our 5 webinar series. Since this being our last webinar and hence the last interactive session for the ongoing 5 webinar series, I hope you guys would be posting as many questions today for us to discuss further. Nikita, how is your experience in hosting this webinar today?
So first of all, I would like to introduce myself to my audience so that they get they're familiar to me. So I'm Nikita from MATLAB Helper, and I'm the host for the live interactive session on image processing using Fuzzy Logic Toolbox. So since it's a live interactive session where you can interact with your audience through their queries, so I hope it will be a great experience on both the sides.
Okay. So before we begin, I'd like to mention that we're giving away special benefits for the top 5 comments. So anybody who has any doubt, feel free to post them in the chat box. That will help you. It might help you win benefit. All right. So to begin with, Nikita, can you explain briefly what fuzzy logic is?
Yes. So fuzzy logic is basically an approach to variable processing that allows multiple values to be processed through same variable. And fuzzy logic attempts to solve problems with an open, imprecise range of data, which gives you variety of outputs, hence to obtain the accurate conclusions. So fuzzy logic is designed to solve problems by considering all available information and making the best possible decision given the output.
Okay, so then there is Boolean logic and fuzzy logic, right?
Yes.
So what is the difference between the two?
Okay, so Boolean logic, first of all, understanding what Boolean logic is, the output in two ways, or in either 0 or 1. But fuzzy logic gives us a range of answers, like ranging from 0 to 1, including 0 and 1. So this is the basic difference between the two. One gives only two inputs, either 0 or 1, and the other gives a variety of.
So can you explain like how the fuzzy logic interference system actually is or looks like?
Okay. So for this, I'll share my screen.
I guess Nikita,
yes.
Nikita's screen is here to share. So anyways, while she is able to share her screen, I'll just ask another question, and this question is for you, Vishaka. As you already know, like we have done a couple of webinars in the past for this 5 webinar series. Can you tell us like if this webinar can be related to any of the previous webinar of this 5 webinar series?
I think we can definitely relate this with the Arduino webinar, because so what basically fuzzy logic does is it acts like a feedback to a control system.
Okay.
So if we have a control system, that is if we have a system and we want it to have a feedback, then we can use it there. So I think as a matter of fact, we will be using the control system design optimization as well as the Arduino related toolboxes for us to work out something on these lines.
Okay, so if that is the sense, we can clearly say like, and that's from my personal experience, I can say Simulink design optimization was trying to optimize your Simulink model. At the same time, control system designer was used for optimizing the parameters of your transfer function and how to choose that. Those were linked. Now Arduino were allowing us to do a couple of functionalities to that. And with the fuzzy logic toolbox, we are able to do all these things combinedly. So it's a mixture of rule-based thing, wouldn't you say?
Yes. So basically, when you talk about the system optimization or the control design toolbox, it is the that is what you do before you design the system.
Okay.
So based on that, we apply the real life applications. So probably when we do the simulant design optimization, it says that the feedback should have this value. So then based on that value, we figure out what the fuzzy logic rules must be.
Okay, so now we are talking about fuzzy logic toolbox. If you can explain to the audience who is quite new to this topic, what really word fuzzy means? If you can explain what this fuzzy refers to.
So fuzzy ideally talks about something that's messy, something that's confusing. So here the logic is not confusing, but you're giving logic to something that is confusing.
We are giving messy rules to it to unmess the thing.
Sort of. So okay. When you say, suppose there is an example of say food and services based on which the tip is being given.
Okay.
So let's just say that if the food is amazing, the tip is going to be amazing. But and the service is amazing, then also the tip will be amazing. And opposite, like when both of them are poor, it's going to be less. But if one of those parameters becomes less, that is the food is good, but the service is bad, the tip is going to be in the middle, right?
Correct.
So if you take it in a Boolean logic, it says that if one of them is a yes, the final answer should be a yes. But here we're talking about a range where even if one is yes and the other is no, we are finding an intermediate value.
Okay, fine. So I see, Nikita, I believe your internet should be better now. So you were trying to answer the question regarding fuzzy toolbox.
Yes.
Yeah, so you can answer now if it's all right.
You're on mute.
Yeah, sure. I'll share my screen. Okay. So you can see that this is a block diagram of fuzzy logic control system. We know that a control system is an arrangement of physical components designed to alter another physical system so that the system exhibits certain desired characteristics. For this, the following diagram shows the architecture of fuzzy logic control. So now let's understand how this operates. In the fuzzification inference, the crisp input values are converted into fuzzy values. Then these fuzzy values are stored in the knowledge base, which has the knowledge about all the input and output fuzzy relationships. It also has the membership function, which defines the input variables to the fuzzy rule base and the output variables. And then here comes the use of the defuzzification inference, and it converts the fuzzy values into crisp values, crisp values which we get again from the fuzzification inference. So this was it. Now let's come to a basic example, like a real life example of how this works. So this is the block diagram of a washing machine. So its goal is to create a fuzzy logic controller for a washing machine that will compute the appropriate washing time based on certain information about the clothes that are to be washed. The schematic view of the system is the schematic view of what will happen, all the inputs and the inside processes. When using the washing machine, the user manually sets the washing time based on the volume of clothes and the degrees of dirtiness in order to transform the washing process into an automatic one. We can use and for this we can even use the sensors to detect the volume of the clothes and also their dirtiness. Then a certain washing time will be chosen based upon the data. The data are the type of dirt and the dirtiness of the clothes, which are the input. And the degree of dirtiness can be determined by examining the transparency of the water. Transparency of the water here actually means that if we soak a dirty cloth into the water, then if the water becomes dirty quite soon, then it means that the cloth has been like very very much dirty. But if we soak it and the water doesn't changes its color soon, then it means that the cloth was not that much dirty. And now we come to another parameter, that is the type of dirtiness. And it can be, this was it that I was talking about. It depends upon the time for which the dirtiness remains. So this is a precise mathematical relation between the inputs and the output. The output is our washing time. So this is the washing time, which is manually set by the user, which is based generally on the previous experience of the user. We generally know that in how much time the certain work will be done. So this applies to our regular experience.
So, Nikita, can you explain what membership functions are?
Yes. Yes, sure. So, a membership function is a curve that defines how each point in the input space is mapped to a membership value or the degree of membership between 0 and 1. The input space is sometimes referred to as a universe of discourse. This is just a fancy name which we have kept for just a simple concept. Vishaka, I want you to share your screen for explaining this function.
Yeah, so basically I'll first explain what's happening here before you explain further. So this is a simple service tip membership, fuzzy logic function system that exists. This is an inbuilt example that's available in MATLAB. So here what it does is it takes two inputs, the service and the food, and then calculates the tip accordingly. Yes, Nikita, you can continue.
For
explaining this, for the membership function, we have got graphs.
Nikita, are you here?
For explaining this membership function, we have got certain graphs. I would like to share my screen. Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Nikita, please share your screen and you can show us what you are trying to explain. And while Nikita shares the screen, Vishaka, since you have been part of the other webinars and you are also part of it, how do you say image processing can be utilized with fuzzy logic and without fuzzy logic? How would be the real difference between the two?
Okay, sure.
Any of you can answer actually.
So if we talk about image processing, I personally feel that using the normal image processing controls, like I am show, I am read, and those basic commands there will definitely help and will be much easier. But in this case, what happens is, we've used fuzzy logic to do image processing because the basic concepts of image processing we've already explained in one of our previous webinars. So based on that, if you're doing image processing, so you understand what has to be done. So it'll be easier for you to understand the logics of fuzzy logic as well.
Is it possible for you to give a very simplest example, like literally something V equal to IR kind of thing for the person who hasn't even seen our previous webinar or who is new to this thing? What would be the basic example of the fuzzy logic?
Fuzzy logic. So shall I explain it with this example that's already there in the
sure,
service
and
the tip of?
Yes. Sure, you can.
So in this case, what's happening, as I mentioned previously, that it takes two inputs, service and the food, and then it calculates the tip accordingly. Now, the membership function that was to be explained is basically this. So the membership function divides whatever is the input. So in this case, it's service. So it divides service into three parts here. And then correspondingly for each group, there is a value between 0 to 1. So suppose you say that the service is, you rate the service as a 0, that means it is 1 in the poor scale. And similarly, the 1 for the good will be a 5. And for the excellent, it will be a 10. Now, this function can obviously change. So here, if you take it as a triangle or a trapezium, this thing changes. Wait, I'll show it here. So this thing changes correspondingly based on what you want it to be as. Okay. So here I will. So as I was explaining earlier, that I give service as 0.93 and the food has a 5 value, the tip correspondingly becomes a 5.5. And if I change the service higher, the tip also changes. Now, the service is amazing and the food is bad. So then you see that it's, you know, it's exactly in the middle, saying, okay, one is extremely good, one is extremely bad. So we sort of compensated by putting it, like having a value in the middle. I personally think that this is the simplest example which is possible, because ideally you don't need a tip calculator, but you're using, so you know, it sort of explains something that you're already clear with the help of rules.
Okay, so in this example you talked about tipping and kind of a restaurant ordering system, something related to that.
Yes.
But when we talk about image processing, then how would you relate some basic example of image processing with fuzzy logic?
When you talk about a basic example of fuzzy logic, so then what happens is you use fuzzy logic to suppose in traffic control and things like that, where there is, you know, you have to take pictures constantly, and then based on those pictures you can sort of say whether the person's violating the rule or how fast the person is moving or how earlier should the person have hit the brake so that this collision does not happen.
All right.
So these are all, when you talk about the braking system, what happens is obviously with respect to there is speed, there is the surface of the road and there's traffic, there's so many things that are considered here that it's not a simple yes or no value. It, you know, you have to consider a lot of parameters, so it becomes a fuzzy system.
Okay, great. All right. Fine. So Nikita, if you are able to hear us now, you can actually discuss about the same thing in depth if you want to. And if the net is still fluctuating, then I'll carry forward. Okay, seems so. So what I'll do is, like, so we are organizing this session on 5th of September. We have been getting a lot of wishes for Teachers Day. So that's great from all the person who are commenting. I wish you everyone for thanking us. I want to thank you guys for wishing us Teachers Day. At the same time, I also want you guys to post your comments regarding any query you might have for this webinar. While we go further, I'll just ask another question to Vishakha. And this question would be related to fuzzy logic. So in the fuzzy logic, there are several set of rules which are supposed to be created. Now, can you explain why these rules are needed or how to implement these rules?
Okay, so to implement rules, most of the fuzzy rules are an if-then rule. So I'll share my screen again. So in this case, if you look at the rules of these, it has three basic rules. It says that if the service is poor or the food is rancid, the tip is cheap. So here, if this condition is true, then why happens? Now here, the service is poor or the food is rancid, these are not something that are actual words. What actually is happening here is in this screen, you can see that we are giving it a range, saying if it's between 0 to 5, then it's a poor value. If it's between, ideally say 3 to 10, then it is entirely in good. Otherwise, it's more or less overlapping with poor and good. And similarly, for excellent, from 8, it's completely in the excellent part, but otherwise, it's grouped between the two. So based on that, this rule divider, it takes the value if it's poor or rancid or whatever, and then calculates the tip accordingly. So all rules in the fuzzy system are an if-then conditional.
Okay, great. So we have received a question in the comment section, and the question is from Manoj. He is asking how this toolbox can be used in medical applications. If any of you can answer this question, it would be great.
Okay, so fuzzy logic toolbox is used in processing medical images, mostly when we have to detect tumors. Like number of pixels detected in the image gives us a clear detection that yes, a tumor is detected in the CT scan of the person. This is the main usage of fuzzy logic in image processing for the medical images.
Okay, great. So hopefully, Manoj, you have got the answer to your query. If you have any counter question, you can respond on the comment section. And Vishakha, you can go to the next question, please.
Yes. So what exactly is the Mamdani method, Nikita? You're mute.
Okay, so you're asking about Mamdani or the difference? I didn't get
Mamdani.
Your voice.
Mamdani.
Okay. So Mamdani, it's a type of inference. It's a method which is used to create a control system by synthesizing a set of linguistic control rules obtained from experience-driven operators. In a Mamdani system, the output of each rule is a fuzzy set, and it enhances the efficiency of the defuzzification process because it greatly simplifies the computation required by the more general Mamdani method, which finds the centroid of a two-dimensional function. Since Mamdani system is more intuitive and easier to understand rule bases, so it is well suited for expert system applications where the rules are created for human expert knowledge, such as the example which we have discussed, medical diagnostics.
So you're basically saying that the system that we showed for the service and the tipper is a Mamdani system, right?
Yes, we have used a Mamdani inference system.
Okay. So I think there is a question Yes, sir.
All right, so yeah, I was actually talking about the question only. We have received a question from Anjali, and she is asking what is fuzzification and how this can be applied in assessing students' performance. If any of you have any idea regarding that.
Okay, so fuzzification is basically a process of converting a crisp input value to a fuzzy value that is performed by the use of the information in the knowledge base. So the various types of curves that we obtain, that is the trapezoidal, the triangular, the Gaussian, they are basically the member functions, and these are the graphs that we obtain in the that we obtain in the fuzzification. For assessing the performance of the student, the triangular curve can be used as like it can show the curve. Okay, for as we have discussed in that tipper problem, it shows a range of outputs. For like from 0 to 3, we have a peak, and from 5 to 8 also we have a peak. So this shows the peak of performance, like how the student has performed.
So when you're talking about students' performance over here, how the student has performed, I would like to get some elaboration on that portion, since we are talking about just performance at this moment and how the student is performing based on the criteria or the rule set. So is it you are talking about grading of the student, or really the just like, okay, whether that person has learnt or not? What you are trying to explain on that, if you can explain it better?
It's sort of grading, like if student it can be taken as an overall, like the whole academic, like if the student has scored good marks and his behavior in class is also good, then the student will be marked as an outstanding student. If the students grades in exams are less, but his behavior is nice, then he can be an average student. Or his marks are good but his behavior is not fine. So these were the rules that we defined, and this can also be taken as an average, like the student taking everything into consideration, the final output will be the average of both.
Okay, so something like we are taking few subjects and then doing their analysis, finding, okay, that's how
yes.
much you have scored. Over here,
yes.
the subjects are being replaced by the rules we have created, and we are
yes.
defining the analysis out of that. Okay,
yes.
great, fine. So, Anjali, we hope you have got the response to your question. If you have any counter question to that, if you haven't we did not answer exactly what you asked, you can explain your question in an elaborate manner. In the meantime, we have received a counter question from Manoj, I guess, and he is asking, do we need to write our own logic, or there any predefined logic in this toolbox, in the fuzzy toolbox?
So there isn't predefined logic. We have to define the logic. There is only a predefined example that is existing, which is the service tipper problem. Otherwise, if you have to write the Nikita's thing, then you have to again write it in your own words. So you'll have to change definitely, but there is no pre-existing logic that is there.
Okay, great. So Anjali has responded back, and she's saying, so by doing this, you are analyzing students' behavior. And I guess you guys would agree with the point, with what you have just explained.
No, sir. We are not entirely analyzing their behavior, but
okay.
an average output. So you have to give an input saying, yes, I think out of 10, this student is 8, or this person is good or bad. Is a good student or a bad student, or he's naughty or he's obedient, and based on that an average output is coming. So we're not exactly analyzing the behavior, but if you actually want to analyze the behavior, I think it'll be way more complex than just what we've explained right now.
Okay, all right. So to be frank enough, it's more just like when we discuss about what really fuzzy is, to do the things which are already messed up and trying to unmesh those things.
Yes.
So if you say the student's performance system, that is quite unmessy, too easy to say what is happening, and you don't really need to do that application on that front. But if required, yes, that could be considered as one of the parameter.
Yes.
I guess that's how it can be said.
Yes.
Okay, great. We have received another question, and this question is from Prem. He is asking, explain the application of fuzzy logic in education.
I think isn't this assessing students already a example for education?
That's true. So that is one of the application. Then I can add on multiple application, which you guys just talked about. Like when you were talking about the restaurant tipping system, that was maybe you can say an example from the business side. On the education front side, when we are talking about this webinar, and in the morning only we discussed about edge detection, then different kind of medical imaging on which we did the performance analysis. So all those things, if you try and consider them through the research-oriented manner, if you try to look into that direction, I feel like there is a scope of development into that, and fuzzy logic creates a lot of application into that research direction. So education would be a very small portion of the research in this field, I guess.
Yes.
Okay. So I guess, Prem, we have responded to your question, but if it's not the exact response, please elaborate your question. And Vishaka, if you want, you can move on to the next question, please.
Okay. So Nikita, like someone from the questions had asked, what exactly is
Yes.
defuzzification? So you explained what fuzzification is, right? So can you sort of brief on what defuzzification is?
Yes. Okay. So defuzzification is a process of obtaining a single number from the output of the aggregated fuzzy set. It is used to transfer the fuzzy inference result into a crisp output. So in other words, we can say that defuzzification is realized by decision-making algorithm that selects the best crisp value based on a fuzzy set.
So fuzzification basically converts all the value into 0 to 1 and then puts
Into
them into sets. So this thing converts it from the sets to the actual value that
to
is
the
measured.
numeric values we want that. Yes.
So is there any specific way to choose a membership function in the fuzzy logic?
Okay. So since membership functions are the building blocks of the fuzzy set theory, so that is the fuzziness in a fuzzy set is defined by the membership function. So accordingly, the shapes of the membership functions are important for a particular problem. Since they affect the fuzzy inference system, they may be of different kinds like triangular, the trapezoidal, or the Gaussian ones.
So according to you, that means it just depends on my data and the way I want to analyze it.
Yes.
All right, so I have one question for you guys. In the previous webinar of image enhancement with MATLAB, we did similar thing, and that was working with CT scan, working with MRIs, etc. And we did those image enhancement technique. We talked about that, and we used the image processing or computer vision toolbox for doing those things. Now, if someone who is doing the similar job, maybe they are doing for their college project or some research project, and since this example of image enhancement with fuzzy, image processing with fuzzy is also doing the same thing, what would you recommend to that person? Image processing toolbox, computer vision, like image processing and computer vision toolbox, or fuzzy logic toolbox, and why would you say that?
I think it depends on how complex the process is.
Okay,
So,
fine, yeah, please elaborate.
yeah. So in the case of the previous webinar, we were finding the blood cell counts. That is basically the image is already there, and you just have to modify the image to get an output. But in certain cases where it's dependent on multiple things, where your output depends on multiple things, then I would suggest that fuzzy logic must be used.
Okay, great. Now we have almost covered up like lots of questions related to fuzzy toolbox, and I guess that's already a lot of queries. If I may ask, I have a question based on image processing. We are doing all these things to the images, but now for someone who is processing on a real-time scenario, we guys go towards video processing. So is it possible to do the video processing through this toolbox, or we just keep it on image processing only? Like, it would be too complex to do.
I think image processing can, sorry, video processing can definitely be done through this toolbox, but I am not aware on how to proceed with it because this toolbox is for complicated situations. So I'm sure you can do this for video processing, but I am not entirely sure on how to go about it. I have not explored that yet.
Okay, no problem. All right, fine. So in the meantime, if you want, you can ask your next question, or we can look through.
Yeah, okay, so we'll wait for like 2 or 3 more minutes in case there are more questions from the YouTube live. In the meanwhile, I'll share the certification procedure. So this is the webinar certification page. There are 25 MCQ questions, but you have to score 60% or more to be eligible for the certification. So here, this bar shows how many the percentage of questions that's completed, and this I am for now answering this randomly. So you can see here that it marks whether it's correct or incorrect. So then, if you keep it in mind, and if you don't get a 60%, you can come back and attempt it as many times as you want. So yeah, and before I move on further, I'd like to mention that the 5 best comments that we mentioned earlier. Those whose name will be taking up soon, though they have to attend this webinar quiz, and they have to send us a screenshot of it on like WhatsApp it to us on this number. This is how we'll be able to contact you. So it's extremely necessary that you attend this quiz within the next 24 hours. And secondly, in a lot of cases, what happens is the name with which you're attempt like commenting on our YouTube live is different from the name you're attempting the quiz with. So ensure that you mention that name in the YouTube live session as well. So the courses that you will be eligible for are the neural network course, numerical method course, the digital signal processing course, and the stock market application. I personally find them extremely interesting, and I hope you avail for these courses as well. So, are there any more questions from the live?
I don't see any questions, but while we wait for any other. Okay, I see there is one question actually. So this question is from Anjali, and she is actually giving her point, not the question. She's saying, in video processing, I guess each FPS is studied by applying fuzzy logic. Fine. If I can add my point towards what I meant with respect to video processing over here is, when we were doing all the thing related to image processing using fuzzy logic toolbox, you were trying to compare two images to get the result, or within the same image you were doing fetching of the essential region which is relevant to the part we are doing. But when we are going towards video processing, it's about within a single second you have multiple frames, and then you have multiple frames, so you may work on that individual frame or you can relate it with the other frame. But ultimately you are going to deal with individual frame only, and those frame becomes images. So essentially speaking, videos are part of multiple images, and we do the same thing on them, what we are doing. But yes, complexity increases considering that single image processing is quite faster. And when you talk about videos, even a 30 frame per second, 10 second video will have 300 frames to process. So depends on how much capability you have, your PC have, and how much you are able to process it quickly. It would surely depend upon that. Okay, so I don't see there is any other question coming. So, should we take the five best comments now?
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So after seeing all the questions, the five best comments are from Manoj, Anjali, Prem, Parth Sharathi, Chakraborty, and Rajesh.
So I hope the winners attempt the quiz and like share with the details with us so that you can avail the benefits.
All right, great. So at this time, I see there is one more question. This question is from Prem, and he is asking difference between neural network and fuzzy logic. Actually, that's an interesting question, if any of you can answer.
When you talk about neural network, you're teaching the computer to start from basic. So you're
Okay.
teaching how you know how the neurons work in our brain. You're sort of teaching the computer to work like that. But when you're talking about fuzzy logic, there are examples. Suppose you consider the service tipper example. You already know that if the food is bad, you're not going to tip highly. You are not teaching the laptop to figure like the algorithm to figure it out on your own. You're saying that if it's bad, you have to give a lower tip. So it's sort of based on your pre-existing knowledge, whereas when you talk about neural network, it's all like you start from the basic.
Okay, great. So thank you guys for giving your valuable feedback. It was really a pleasant session with you guys, and you have really given a lot of insightful things regarding fuzzy logic toolbox and then also an image processing thing. At this point of time, I would also like to say that during the past four webinars of this five webinar series, which started from Simulink Design Optimization, then it went further with 2D environment mapping with Arduino and ThingSpeak, later with Control System Designer Toolbox, and last session, which was on Mapping Toolbox. So we have actually covered up multiple toolboxes, or maybe Arduino, I can't say as a toolbox. That's an add-on to the MATLAB. So we have covered toolbox and add-ons. How much, if we talk about complexity among all those five things, which one a beginner of MATLAB should be looking forward as a first point of entry towards learning something, if you guys can actually give them a suggestion?
I personally think that going with the Simulink Design Toolbox or the Mapping Toolbox will be a little easier. But in terms of Arduino, I think you get live outputs, so I think it'll be more interesting in terms of in a basic way that you can see the LED glow and things like that. So
Okay.
yeah, but then this webinar definitely becomes very, it's a little high intermediate level when you talk about fuzzy logic toolbox.
Okay. So I see Prem has responded back, and he's asking give example between the two, which you mentioned as a difference, sign difference. That was considering about fuzzy logic and neural network, I guess.
I can give a very basic example of neural network where you implement the AND gate. So what happens is you have nodes specifically, and then you sort of give them weights, saying that if the input is a 1 and the AND, suppose there are two inputs AND, if the first input is a 1 and the second input is a 0, this minute, I'll share my screen so that it becomes easier. I can explain
Sure.
it there. Yes. So there are two networks here. This is your input, and this calculates your output. So this takes the value A and B. So when you talk about sorry for this, but this is a B. But so basically, when you say that, suppose it has to be an AND gate or a NOR or gate, for an AND gate, it has to be only triggered when both of them are 1. So then what happens is you apply some logic here such that when both of them are 1, it triggers it to get 1. So when you talk about a neuron, what it basically does is it has a threshold value. Once you cross that threshold value, the neuron is fired and the message is being relayed. So that is how basically this AND gate will work, where you give it a trigger, and then based on these trigger threshold values, you will get an output here. Whereas in if you can see, these are all, any system that you take is a series of AND or NORs, something like that. So you have to apply this to a larger level to be able to get a neural system out of it. But when you talk about fuzzy systems, I think if I go back to the service and TIPO program, there you already know it becomes much simpler as compared to neural network, in at least this example, where you're saying that, you know, if the code is good or the service is bad, accordingly you give a tip, but it's still much easier. Whereas here you're teaching it to start from the beginning, saying ki, if it is one and one, then you give an output as one. So you start from very basic.
Okay, so thank you for responding to this question, Vishakha. Hopefully, Prem, you have got the answer to your query. If you still have any question, please, you can post it in the discussion section on the website page, or directly as a comment on this YouTube, not in the live chat, but in the normal chat. And I guess we have discussed all the comments which we have received. Would you like to add anything from your side, Vishakha or Nikita, before we end the session?
I think I've had an amazing time answering these questions today, and I hope their doubts have also been cleared.
All right. Anything from your side, Nikita, before we end the session?
Since it has been mentioned that this fuzzy logic toolbox is sort of a thing which is of that intermediate level. So everyone might be curious about knowing more about it. So you all definitely get in touch with us on our website or on WhatsApp.
All right, great. So that was a great time with every one of you. Hopefully you guys would have enjoyed this session. And we are looking forward for you to participate in our webinars, quizzes, and courses. So thank you, everyone, and have a great day.